Hello there, welcome! Let's see very quickly how to use Corel VideoStudio Pro X7. Leave feedbacks in comments to improve our videos. VideoStudio Pro is a professional video editing software used to edit and create video projects involving pictures, videos and text. This software has three different workspaces. Capture is used to import files, edit to create your project, and share to export it. You will mainly use the edit and the share one, so we will see just these two. The edit section is composed by two main parts. On top you have two different windows, the preview on the left and the tools on the right. These contain all you need to work with your clips. On the other half, you have the timeline, where you will edit and manage your files to create your video. Let's start importing files. You can import simply selecting the files and dragging them from any folder to the timeline. It is better to import them one by one, since you do import files if you add them to the right track, as we will see shortly. So you can add three main kinds of files: videos, pictures and sounds. And the ones imported in the timeline are also called clips. These include the name of the file and its kind through a small icon on the left. Videos that do have sound will show a loudspeaker icon too. Videos and images are always inside overlay tracks, the ones with this icon on the left. Audio clips are inside the voice or the music tracks, the last two ones you find. You can use one or the other, it's the same. There is a fourth kind of clip, which is the text. This has a known track, called the title track, indicated through a T icon. We will see this later. After importing, you may have the project settings in a wrong resolution. To set it, just go to Settings on top, and then to Project Properties. In this new window, choose the right resolution. For example, if you want to upload HD in YouTube, choose Online in Project Format. Select the one you prefer and go to OK below. The name and the resolution appear in the top right corner. Moreover, your clip may not match the new resolution. The clip may cover just some parts of the total resolution. To adapt the clip, simply select the clip interested. Some nodes will appear on the clip. You can click and drag the yellow ones to scale the clip. Use the small green ones to skew and distort instead. In case you mistake with anything, simply press Ctrl and Z to undo. The preview contains also the player, so you can play and stop the project from there. You can also use a space key to play and stop fast. As long as the preview is in project mode, you will play how your whole project is going, including all the clips that are in your timeline. But if you click on Clip, you can edit and scale the clip, as seen, and the player refers to the clip selected at the moment, and plays as it lasts. To select a clip, simply click on it. This will be highlighted in orange color. You can check your project fixing the playhead. On top of the timeline, you have a time grid. If you click there, you will fix the playhead, and the preview shows how is your project on that frame. You can drag the playhead to check the wall motion. Let's see how to edit clips. You can move a clip in time, selecting and dragging it on the left or right. You can place it to another track in the same way. Mind that the track's order sets which are the clips that must appear above any other. The clips that are in a lower track are shown on the clips that stay on upper tracks. To edit a clip's length, simply drag its edges. In this case, the pointer becomes a black double arrow. You can turn long video and sound clips over their natural duration, since they do have a beginning and an end. If you want them to last longer, you can loop them over and over. To copy and paste a clip, simply select it and press Ctrl and X. The software shows you a new copy in white. Decide where to place it and the new copy is done. Whereas to delete a clip, simply select it, right-click and go to Delete, or press Delete key from your keyboard. If you don't want to loop the clip, you can always trim it. Trimming a clip means to elong or shorten the clip, changing its playing speed. To do this, simply drag the edges while holding Shift down. You will see that the double arrow is white in this case. A percentage tells you how much you are changing the playing speed of the clip. If you elong the clip, it will be played slower, otherwise faster. Mind, this affects the sound parts too, of course, but keeping the same pitch. You can also split a clip in two. Select the clip to split, place the playhead properly, and press the S letter key of your keyboard. On top, on the right, you have anything the Video Studio offers. We will see just the main important tools. The media section collects all sample files that the software offers you. Instant Projects has ready-made templates for your project, try it out. Then, if you have clips that do overlap on the same track, a transition is made. This is an effect that lets you pass from the first clip to the second one in a cool way. These are all listed in the Transition section. Select one to check it. To edit between the two clips overlapped, simply drag it on them. You can change the duration overlapping clips for a shorter time. If you want to remove the transition, simply put clips distant enough. You can add transitions to the beginning or the ending part of a clip as well, to make it appear or disappear. Filter adds effects to your visible clips, such as videos and pictures. As seen with transitions, simply click and drag one on a clip. An orange FX icon appears, showing you that there is an effect active. By default, if you drag another effect, the previous one is removed. If you select the clip and click on Options in the bottom right corner, you can uncheck Replace Last Filter in Attribute section to add on and on more effects at once. This window lets you edit a clip much more into deep. Through Edit, you can adjust the appearance of the pictures, such as color, lineness or any zoom. Depending on the kind of the clip, you can have video instead of the edit section in video clips, where you can change the appearance or the playing speed. There is also split audio. Videos do have the audio part included inside by default. But if you click here, video and audio will be separated in two different clips, and a cross appears next to the loudspeaker icon on the original clip, meaning that the video clip doesn't include sound anymore. Through attribute, you have several other options. Mask and chroma key is used to add some transparency. Try it. Apply all with the X button in the top right corner. The list on the left contains all the effects or filters applied. You can delete one through the cross on the right. You can customize one selecting it and going to Customize Filter. There are many and many advanced options here. Try them when you get some more experience. For some clips, you won't have the edit and the attribute sections, but you still have advanced options like the mixer or the speed management. When you are done, click on the blue arrow in the top right corner to close all. Let's make some text. Go to title section. Just choose a template and add it to the title track or an overlay track. If you want to start from zero, you can always double-click on the preview window while you are in the title section. Type inside and click elsewhere to apply. Then you can click and drag to place the text and use the yellow and the violet nodes to scale and rotate. The options section, seen before, opens, showing you all to edit the text in font, size, distribution and alignment. Always select the text to apply the changes. You can even add borders, shadow and transparency below. Double-click on the text to type inside again. Text clips are represented in green and have as names the first part of the text content. Then it behaves like a normal visible clip, so you can add transitions or effects seen before. While you work, you can use your mouse wheel to move on the left or right. Hold Ctrl down to zoom in and out. You can show off new tracks clicking on the track manager icon on top of the tracks list. You can also enable or disable a track clicking on the related icon. A disabled track hides all its clips inside, which means that pictures and videos become invisible and audio clips muted. Once your project is finished, save and export it. Go to File and then to Save As. To save the project as a .vsp file. In this way you can open it later to edit it. To export your project, so to obtain the final video, go to Share. At the bottom of the preview, place the orange markers to decide which parts of the project to render. On the center, choose the destination, a DVD, a device, a website, or your own hard disk. Each destination has its own options on the right. For a major control, choose to upload in your computer. Here you can choose the file format and the resolution through profile. choose below Name and Destination folder. Then go to Start. Thanks for watching this video. Check our channel for more amazing software guides.